Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. We are now with Tam Sir. So we didn't see face to face for couples of weeks, okay? After the Hari Raya holiday. So now we return to the live biology lesson. Okay. So starting from this week, we need to shift our lesson the time. Okay, reschedule the lessons to 3 p.m. of every Tuesday because teachers have to return to school to work, okay, to teach and for meeting. For example, for me, for today, I went back to school for meeting, so I was unable to be with you, okay, in the morning, okay, 11 a.m. for the live lesson. Okay, so for this lesson, okay, we'll start very soon, 3:05, since this is the first time we rescheduled time to 3 o'clock. So we wait for the others to join us, okay, at 3:05. Okay, so for today's lesson, I will spend around 1 hour. Okay, so I will not delay your time. Okay, I will not spend too much of time from you. Okay, let's see who are on board with us. Okay, let's see. Shen Yi, Lee Shen Yi, who is Lee Shen Yi? Is it from our class? Okay, 4S1 or 4S6? Okay, yes, Jen Jun. Okay, good afternoon. Jia Jun, hello. Hong Liang, Shao Qian. And Jen Hao from S6. Okay, Chin King, Stephen Lai Ziyang, Jun Wei, Xin Kai, Sheng Xian, Teo Bun Shun, Dan Jia Xuan, Mei Yong Ping, Tan Jun Hao. Wow. So happy to see you all here. Okay, Ong Ding Chow, Chow Chun K, Re Rong. Hey, Re Rong, I thought you are not free since you did not select this time. Okay, it's glad to see you here, Re Rong. Okay, Chan Shi Jian, Calvin Ng, Yi Kang, Zhen Kai, Anthony, Zi Yu, Li Zhiyang, Yao Ming. Okay, next one, we see who is with us. After Yao Ming, Man Hong, Zi Hong, Wing Shan, Re Zhao, Yi Kang. Wow, we didn't see each other for 3 months. I nearly forget your face. Yes, to be honest. Okay, but I still remember your name. Okay, this one. Okay, this name from S1 or this boy is from S6. But for some students, sorry, really very sorry. I really forget your face, your look. Okay, Tian Pang, hello, Jun Chao. And the last one, it's Henry. Okay, so the time now is 3:05. So for those who are unable to join the class, okay, or if you have any classes, online classes with your tuition teachers, okay, or for any sub or for other subjects, you may watch this video, okay, once again after when we are free, because this video is recorded in the YouTube. Okay, so shall we start now? Okay, so for today's lesson, it's very easy, okay? And I will give you the assignments after the lesson, okay? Tomorrow I will share this assignment in the Google Classroom. So, shall we start now? Okay, remember to have your lunch first, okay? If you want to go to toilet, just go ahead. You just carry your laptops, okay? Your handphone to the toilets, but you are unable to carry your desktop. So sorry. Okay, so can we start? Hello, Jian Yi, and hello, Zhao Sheng. Welcome on board with me. Okay, so do not leave the classroom, man. Do not leave the classroom because I will ask questions anytime. So don't just type your name to entertain me, show your face for a while, no face at all, show your name for a while, and you left. Okay, so no. You are not allowed to do so because I will ask question. I will ask question. I will call your name. So if you are not no response, which means you are playing truant bonding class. Okay, so let's check. Okay, so let's start the lesson. Okay, are you ready, everyone? Okay, so you have all ready. So at your place there, you say, "Hello, sir, I'm ready. Sir, I'm ready." But I can't listen. I can't hear what you say. Okay, so we may start now. Okay. Okay, so class, in our bio lesson, last two chapters, we talked about the respiration and also the gaseous exchange. Why? Because air is very crucial for human beings or for all living organisms. So we need air for survival. So in the first chapter, first two chapters of the physiology, so we studied about the respiration as well as the gaseous exchange. Okay, so we also need food for survival. And therefore, in this lesson, we'll focus on nutrition. So what is the meaning of nutrition? So nutrition, this is the process of obtaining nutrients and energy. Okay, so why do we need nutrients and energy? Okay, so as we know that, okay, for cellular respiration, the main substrate is the glucose. So we obtain glucose from the nutrition, and we also need nutrients for growth. So all of these, everything, okay, we obtain nutrients and energy from food. Okay, so from this, for this lesson, from the beginning until the end, I've talked about the pizza. So you can order your pizza right now. Okay, customize your pizza. Okay, so this lesson, chapter 9, is about the nutrition and the human digestive system. Okay, so before starting the lesson, let's customize your pizza. So for the pizza, we have the crust, okay? In Chinese means the 饼皮. Okay, so you can order the thick crust or the thin crust, depends on your preference. Okay, so now I would like to know which is your preference. You like what type of crust? Okay, I will select your name. So don't bonding class. Okay, Tan Jia Xuan, are you here? So please select the type of crust you like. You like a thin crust or a thick crust for the pizza? Hello, Jia Xuan, where are you? Okay, you prefer a thin crust or a thick crust for the pizza? Okay, because for this lesson, from the beginning until the end, we talked about the pizza. Okay, it's about the nutrition. Hello, Jia Xuan, are you here? Or you went for Kawakaki for your KRS, okay? Or you went for choir practice? Where are you, Tan Jia Xuan? Okay, so you prefer a thin crust or a thick crust, okay, to customize your own pizza. Jia Xuan, are you reverse? Okay, so while waiting for you, yes, Tan Jia Xuan, yes, you okay? Yeah, you like a thick crust. Okay, Jia Xuan, okay, prefer a thick crust, okay, for its pizza. Okay, so next one about the toppings. Okay, what toppings do you like, okay, to be put on the top of the pizza? So I'd like to select other student from 4S6. Okay. Liu Junwei, where are you? Are you here, Liu Junwei? Are you with us? So, what type of toppings do you want to put on the top of your pizza? Toppings, Liu Junwei from 4S6. Are you with us, Liu Junwei? Come on, don't hide yourself. I will check one by one. Okay, so I'll select three students, okay, to tell us, to share with us what is your favorite toppings. Okay, the cheese. Yes, man. Thank you for your response, Junwei. Okay, so Junwei, select cheese as the toppings. Okay, the next one, I'd like to select, okay, another one from 4S1. How about Man Hong? So other than cheese as a topping, so what do you select? Okay, so another one is 4S6, okay, Yo Man Hong, you can write your answer, type your answer right now. Okay, so another one, which is Mei Yong Ping from 4S6. So what toppings do you like, okay, to customize your own pizza? So no more, you can't choose cheese because of, yes, pineapple, thank you very much. Oh, this one is Aloha, pineapple. Another one is Mei Yong Ping, mushroom. Wait, wow, all of you vegetarian, you don't like to eat meat, is it? Okay, so for me, I select because this class is between you and me, so I would like to select my own, my favorite toppings. Okay, so I would like to add some chicken, okay, because I like to eat chicken breast, okay, rich in protein, okay, chicken breast, B-R-E-A-S-T, I like breast. Okay, so next one, so remember our pizza, okay, thick crust, okay, with cheese on as a toppings, we have pineapple, and then we have mushroom, and then we have chicken breast. Okay, so let's go. Okay, so now we relate nutrition to the human digestive system. Okay, so now the pizza you customize, okay, is already served now. Every one of you. So Mr. Tam, okay, Tam, so I haven't had my pizza, had my lunch yet. So now I'm having my pizza. So now for the digestive system, the first part of the digestive organ, okay, which is your mouth, okay, because your food will enter, this is your first destination where your food enters the digestive system, which means your mouth or the, this is a grill, just now you customize, man. So now everything is ready for all of you, the pizza. Okay, so now let's see. The oral cavity or the mouth is the first part of the digestive system. Okay, so now the pizza enters the mouth. Okay, so we chew the food, okay, like me, I'm chewing the pizza into smaller pieces. Later, I will ask you, what's the reason? Okay, we need to chew the food into small pieces. Okay, so next one. Okay, now, once after it is chewed, it is grind into small pieces. So this no longer food, it becomes a substance known as bolus. Okay, remember this term, bolus, B-O-L-L-U-S, bolus. So at your side, okay, please repeat this, B-O-L-L-U-S, bolus, B-O-L-U-S, bolus. So this bolus is swallowed, okay, and it enters through a tract, and this tract is known as the esophagus. Okay, the length of the esophagus is around 20 cm to 25 cm, depends on different individual. So the length of the esophagus, okay, it's around 20 to 25 cm. So now the food continues to move, okay, from the esophagus into the next part of the digestive system, which is the stomach. Okay, so the food will stay in the stomach for around 2 to 5 hours. So from the stomach, okay, so now the bolus no longer bolus. Okay, we will give it another name, which is known as the chyme. C-H-Y-M-E. Chyme. I repeat, C-H-Y-M-E. Chyme. Okay, so now the chyme will leave the stomach. Okay, and then to the next part of the digestive system. Wow. So this one, which is the small intestine. So the length of small intestine, okay, it's around 3 to 5 meter, depends on the individual. Okay, so next one, this substance, okay, so the food particles, okay, will move along the small intestine until it reaches the large intestine. So another name for large intestine is known as the colon. Okay, so follow me to pronounce this, colon. So the length of colon is around 1.5 meter. Okay, so from the colon, there are three parts. Okay, going up is the ascending colon. Okay, ascending colon, horizontal one. Okay, I repeat that. Okay, I go back. So going up, okay, going up is the ascending colon, horizontal one, which is the transverse colon. And going down is a descending colon. Okay, so this is the ascending colon, transverse colon, and descending colon. And now the next part becomes the feces. So now the feces will be stored in the rectum and then will be expelled through the anus. So from the part where food goes in, which is your mouth, until the feces goes out, so this part, we know this as the digestive tract or the alimentary canal. Okay, so next one. Other than these parts, so the digestive system also contains, okay, consists of the salivary glands, okay, the liver, the gallbladder, So the function of liver is to secrete a juice known as bile. Bile in Chinese means 胆汁. So this bile is stored in the gallbladder. So the relationship between liver and gallbladder, liver produce bile, secrete bile, whereas gallbladder store bile. Another one, which is pancreas. So all of these parts, they are known as accessory organs in the human digestive system. Okay, they are not considered as the alimentary canal or the digestive tract. Why? Because the food, it does not pass through these parts. They are just accessory organ to help digestion. Okay, so now we go to the next part. Digestive system can be okay. So for the digestive system, can be divided into four main stages. So start from the digestion. Okay, so once after the food is digested, it becomes the digested nutrients. So these digested nutrients are absorbed in the small intestine, okay, and followed by assimilation. And lastly, the undigested food will be expelled through the anus through a process known as defecation. So digestive system is not only focused on the digestion, but also the absorption, assimilation, and defecation. Okay, so for digestion, it takes place in the mouth, okay, stomach, as well as the small intestine. So for today's lesson, we will fully focus on digestion. So for absorption, assimilation, and defecation, next week, I will talk about it. So for absorption, the digested nutrients are absorbed in the small intestine, and assimilation takes place in the liver. And lastly, for defecation, it involves the large intestine, okay, the rectum, and the anus. So today we just focus on the first part, which is digestion. Okay, so what's the meaning of digestion? Okay, so let's say when we order pizza from Pizza Hut, Domino Pizza, or any restaurant, so you order one pan of pizza, but you are unable to eat. Your mouth is not so big to fit this one big pan of pizza. So this pizza is sliced, okay, it's cut into slices, just like this one, cut into slices, so it can be fit in your mouth. Okay, so same for digestion. What is the purpose of digestion? Okay, we must remember the next step after digestion is absorption. Okay, because your small intestine is unable to absorb such a big pizza. So you need to break down these large and complex molecules into smaller, simple, soluble molecules. So remember this 3S, simple, smaller, soluble molecules. And this digestion is the breakdown from large to small, so that these nutrients, these molecules can be absorbed easily by the small intestine. So this is the reason why we need digestion. Okay, so next part, I will go to, there are two types of digestion. Okay, the first one, which is the physical digestion. Another one, which is the chemical digestion. Okay, so for physical digestion, let's see. There are three questions. Okay, I want to ask you three questions. What is physical digestion? You must know what is it. How does it occur? And why is it important? So for both physical digestion and chemical digestion, you need to ask yourself these three questions. What is this? And how does it occur? And why is it important? Okay, so for physical digestion, which is the breakdown of food, just like my pizza, okay, pizza into small pieces. Okay, let's say for physical digestion, now I chew, I bite, and I chew into small pieces. So this is the physical digestion. How? So I'm chewing, right? So by slicing, by chewing, by grinding. So slicing, chewing, and grinding are the actions of your teeth. So you use your teeth to slice, to chew, to grind, as well as the peristalsis. Okay, so after this slide, I will explain what is the meaning of peristalsis. So I believe when you were in Form 1, Form 2, Form 3, you know this meaning, peristalsis. And why is this important? Okay, so now, I have a question for you. Why physical digestion is important? Okay, I'll give you the hint. From big to small. Okay, I'm going to select student to answer. Okay, Han Ji Ong. Siapa Han Ji Ong? GNG is it? Okay, Kenji, are you here? Are you with us, Kenji Ong? Okay, so for Kenji, there's a question for you. Why physical digestion is important? Let's give your answer. Type in the chat box. I'm going to check now your attendance. Okay, day timing from 4SX, sleep late, jaw away. Sleep late, jaw now, what's the time? 3:30, sleep late, jaw. And Ho Yuwing, welcome. Okay, so Kenji Ong, are you here with us? So what is the importance of physical digestion? Why do we need physical digestion from big to small? Okay, I'm waiting for your answer. Everyone is waiting for your answer. So while waiting for you, I need to drink something. I'm very thirsty. I told you already, I will check from time to time whether you are still unavailable, still with us or not. Kenji Ong, are you with us? Why physical digestion is important? Hey, okay, so while waiting for your answer, so let's talk about our lesson, okay? So for your homework, I've checked your own homework that you sent to the photo album, okay? So well done to some of you have submitted, but those who owe me homework, I need your reason. Okay, yeah. So please give me your reason why you owe me your homework. So you must complete your homework. Okay, because I give enough time for you to complete. Hey, you see this Kenji Ong missing already. Okay, next. I don't want to wait for you. Okay, Henry. Okay, so Henry, are you here? Henry, are you here with us? Henry Chong, 4S1. Henry, are you with us? If you are here, say yes. Henry, yes, okay, so why physical digestion is important? Okay, the hint is from big to small. Okay, I give you another hint. Just like the alveolus, we have a big alveolus, but there are a big structure, but it is fine divided into smaller parts, alveoli. So from big to many small parts, okay? So the reason actually is same, okay? Yes, so I'm waiting for your answer, Henry. Okay, so please type your answer, So now I'm showing you the reason. So to provide large total surface area of food, so for the chemical digestion, so when the food is chewed into smaller pieces, so this can increase the total surface area for the next part, which is the chemical digestion. Okay, so next one. Okay, just now I talked about the peristalsis. Okay, so this peristalsis is one of the physical digestion. Okay, so let's see, what's the peristalsis? Okay, we observe this is the movement of the bolus along the esophagus that move, okay, the bolus along the esophagus and then enters the stomach. Okay, so for peristalsis, this is the rhythmic contraction and relaxation of smooth muscle. So rhythmic means contraction and relaxation, okay, occurs alternately. Okay, so it pushes the bolus through the esophagus and then into the stomach. Okay, so this is peristalsis. So for peristalsis, this term is not only limited for the contraction and relaxation of smooth muscle along the esophagus, but also can be used in the movement of substances, okay, in the stomach, as well as the movement of the nutrients along the small intestine. So this peristalsis is not limited for esophagus, but also for the movement of substances in the stomach as well as along the small intestine. Okay, so next we go to the next part. Okay, another digestion, which is the chemical digestion. So for this chemical digestion, okay, same, what, how, why? So what, okay, this is a hydrolysis. So boys use this term, hydrolysis. Okay, when you see this hydrolysis, it involves the breakdown of water molecule from complex molecules into simple molecules. So which means chemical digestion, this is considered as a metabolism. From big to small, from big to small. So this is catabolism, catabolism. How? Okay, so for chemical digestion, it involves enzymes. So in chapter 5, okay, I have introduced different types of enzymes, and you should know how is the enzyme's reaction and why it's for absorption by the small intestines. Okay, so next, I go to the next part. So digestion, here there are three terms you need to know. The first one is the digestive glands, digestive juice, as well as digestive enzymes. So for these glands, function is to secrete the juice, okay? And the juice contains enzyme. Okay, so now we can relate gland to juice. Gland secrete juice. Juice contain enzyme. Okay, and this enzyme is to hydrolyze. Okay, remember, we use this term. Okay, you can use breakdown. You can use digest, but I prefer you to use hydrolyze. Okay, this one, high class a bit, ma. So hydrolyze, it involves the breakdown of water molecule, hydrolyze the substrates into products. So the substrates here refer to the large and complex molecules. And the products here are referred to the simple, smaller, soluble molecules. Okay, so let's, yeah. I believe you know about this, okay, digestion when you were in form 1, form 2, form 3, or even when we talk about, okay, the chemical composition in the cell, okay, in chapter 4, I've mentioned proteins, carbohydrates, and lipids. So, the end products of digestion of carbohydrates, they are the monosaccharides. Okay, so it's time to do a revision for what you studied previously. Okay, no need to tell me the answer, but you tell your own. What are the examples of three monosaccharide? Test yourself right now. Okay, three monosaccharide. Okay, GGF, glucose, galactose, and fructose. Okay, so these are all the end products. And proteins, for sure, amino acids, and lipids, glycerol, and fatty acids. Okay, so in the food contains seven classes. Okay, we have seven classes of food. Okay, we have carbohydrate, proteins, lipids as a nutrients. Other than these three, okay, we have the food contains, okay, water, okay, and then we have vitamins. We need minerals. We also need fibers. Now, how about vitamins, minerals, and fibers? What are the end products of this digestion? Okay, I give you the answer. There is no end products of digestion of vitamins, minerals, and fiber, because for vitamins, minerals, and fibers, they are not hydrolyzed, they are not digested at all. Okay, so give me the reason. Okay, why? Okay, I give you the first question. Why digestion, okay, of vitamins and minerals, okay, does not occur? Why digestion of vitamins and minerals does not occur? And why fibers cannot be digested? Okay, why fibers cannot be digested? Two questions. Okay, so question number one, okay, it's open to, okay, why vitamins, minerals, okay, the digestion of vitamins and minerals does not occur. So this question is for, okay, I'm gonna select one guy to answer this question. Lu Jiajun, are you here with us? Lu Jiajun. If you are here, type yes, Lu Jiajun. Okay, another one for 4S6, 4S6. Li Ziyang, are you reverse? Okay, Lu. Yes, Lu. The first question for you is for you. Okay, why fibers cannot be digested? Why fibers cannot be digested? Please give me your answer. And Li Ziyang, are you with here? Are you with us right now, Li Ziyang? If you are here, please type yes. Okay, so Jia Jun, give me your answer. Okay, and Ziyang, are you here with us? Hey, missing again. Where do you hide yourself, Li Ziyang? 4 at 6. Okay, so I'll throw this question to another guy. Chan Zihong, are you with here? Are you with us now? Ah, Li Ziyang here. Okay, Chan Zihong, no need to answer. Li Ziyang, I give you another question. I give you the second question. Okay, so digestion of vitamins and minerals does not occur. Give your reason. Give your reason. Okay. Yeah, Kenji Ong, sir, I'm back. Where did you go? Camping, scout camping, is it? Okay, now Lu Jiajun, your question is why fibers cannot be digested? Okay, and Li Ziyang, your question. Okay, digestion of vitamins and minerals does not occur. Give your reason. So I'm waiting for both answers. Okay, so while waiting for both of the answers, I move to the next part. Okay, So keep slow, because at the end of the lesson, I will tell you the answer for Lu Jiajun and Li Ziyang. So now I go to the next slide. Okay, now Lu Jiajun got answer ready. Okay, this is because the lack of appropriate enzymes to break down the beta-lactacetyl linkage. Wow. So what is the enzyme? Okay, so boys and no boys and girls, just boys. So for human, we do not produce an enzyme known as cellulase. Okay, so to break down fibers, actually fibers are made of cellulose. So because in our digestive system does not produce cellulase, so no cellulase, how to hydrolyze cellulose? Okay, actually your answer is right. What is the enzyme? So the enzyme is cellulase. Okay, and the next one, why vitamin for digestion and vitamins and minerals does not occur? Give your reason. Okay, Li Ziyang, I'm waiting for your answer. Okay, so next, we go to the next slide. So next part, for this lesson, we just focus on the digestion. So there are three sites of digestion, three main sites of digestion. So the first one, it's a mouth. Okay, chemical digestion takes place in the mouth. Okay, so boys, for this digestion here, it's referred to the chemical digestion. So it takes place in the mouth. So the stomach is also the next site. Okay, another site of digestion, as well as the small intestine. Okay, boys, so let's see. The small intestine can be divided into three parts. So the first part, which is known as the duodenum. So duodenum is the proximal part, which means this part is nearest to the stomach. Okay. And for duodenum, its shape is like a C shape. Okay, let's see. This is the duodenum. This part, duodenum, and it is near to the stomach. It's the proximal part, proximal to the stomach. Okay, so for duodenum, its length is around 25 cm. So we call this duodenum as, in Chinese, that means 十二指肠, means 12 fingers. The intestine of the 12 fingers. Why? Because its length, is when you arrange your fingers, now you have five fingers, 10 fingers, and you add another 2 fingers, so total 12 fingers. So when these 12 fingers, they line up parallelly, so the length of the duodenum, is equal, is near to the length of 12 fingers when they line up arranged in the parallel line. Okay, so the second part, which is a jejunum, and the last one is the ileum. Okay, so for side of digestion, of chemical digestion first takes place in the mouth, followed by stomach, okay, and also the small intestine. But now I'm going to be more detailed. The third part, which is in the duodenum, and the fourth part, which is the ileum. So in jejunum, okay, chemical digestion does not occur. So there are four main sites of digestion, namely the mouth, stomach, duodenum, and ileum. Okay, let's check. Hey, just now, Lizzie, I'm asking you a question and why there is no answer. Okay, so now I'm still waiting for your answer, Lizzie. Okay, so for the small intestine, okay, duodenum and ileum are the sites of digestion. Okay, we just ignore jejunum. So there are four sites. Okay, so let's see the first one in the mouth. So this is the first site of digestion. So just now I have told you, when you talk about digestion, there are three important terms. First, digestive gland, the gland. Second, digestive juice. The fourth one is a digestive enzyme. So in the mouth, okay, so the digestive glands are known as the salivary glands. Okay, so these are the salivary glands. So I circle these parts. These are the salivary gland. And the juice, salivary gland, secrete. Okay, so we use this term, secrete. Salivary gland secretes saliva. And saliva contains enzymes. Okay, which is the salivary amylase. Salivary amylase. So for this amylase is the enzyme to hydrolyze starch. Starch is the substrate. Okay, let's see. Oh, before going to the reaction. Okay, so for salivary amylase, okay, the optimum pH, okay, for enzyme. Okay, let's do a revision now. In the previous chapters, we talked about the enzyme. There are four factors affecting the activity of enzymes. The first one, temperature. The next one, pH, concentration of substrate, as well as the concentration of enzymes. Okay, so for salivary enzymes, they work best at a pH of 6.5 to 7.5. It's neutral condition. So now, if let's say, if your mouth is too acidic, let's say if you add very acidic food, so which means the salivary amylase, okay, cannot function well, okay, in the acidic condition. So after taking acidic food, you need to gargle your mouth, okay. So that's the reaction. Well, okay, so let's see this equation. Actually, there are three parts you need to know. Okay, so for the starch, this is the substrate. Okay, and then next one, maltose, this is the product. And salivary amylase, this is the enzyme. Okay, now this is actually same as what we studied previously, okay, in the previous chapter. Enzymes, okay, for an enzyme activity, okay, the substrate, okay, will bind to the active site of the enzyme to form enzyme substrate complex, okay, and then products are formed. So in this case, the starch is the substrate, okay, and it is hydrolyzed by the salivary amylase to become maltose. Okay, so since this is hydrolysis, which means it involves the breakdown of water molecule. Okay, so next part, I will go to the next site. Okay, because for chemical digestion, there are four sites. Okay, the first one, which is in the mouth. So now we will move to the stomach. Okay, so the wall of the stomach is lined by epithelial cells. Okay, wait, still remember what's epithelial cells or not? In the beginning of form four, I've introduced there are four main, okay, types of tissue. So one of the tissue, which is known as the epithelial tissues. Okay, so for the wall of the stomach, Okay, it is lined by epithelial cells. Okay, epithelial cells, and there are three types. Okay, and these epithelial cells can be divided into more detail. So the first one, okay, we look from the bottom. Okay, from the bottom. Okay, which is a chief cells. So these chief cells will produce a secret enzyme known as pepsinogen, and this pepsinogen is an inactive enzyme. Okay, and then another one, the second one, which is the parietal cell. So parietal cells secrete hydrochloric acid. So the function of hydrochloric acid, okay, so the first one, function of hydrochloric acid is to kill microorganisms. Okay, so the second function of hydrochloric acid is to provide an acidic condition for the enzymes in the stomach. Okay, and the next one, okay, for parietal cells is to stop the reaction of salivary amylase. Okay, because when we swallow the food, the saliva, okay, will be swallowed together with the bolus. So when the saliva, okay, enters the stomach, okay, as we know, the saliva contains salivary amylase. Because of this acidic condition, okay, the enzymatic reaction of salivary amylase will be stopped because of too acidic. Okay, and then mucus, the third one, which is the mucus cell that secrete mucus to protect the wall of the stomach. Okay, so the function of mucus is to protect the wall of stomach. Okay, so boys, now these chief cells, parietal cells, and mucus cells, they are actually epithelial cells. When all of them combine together collectively, okay, now I go to the next slide already lah, huh? So yeah, now in the stomach, the digestive gland is known as the gastric gland in the stomach. So this gastric gland include the three types of cell that I mentioned previously. The first one, which is the mucous cell, the second one, which is the parietal cell, and the third one, which is the chief cell. Okay, so for this gastric gland, it contains the mucous cell. Okay, I showed you the mucous cell, parietal cell, and the chief cell. So, and mucous cell, sorry. Okay, and then parietal cell and the chief cells, collectively known as the gastric gland. Okay, and gastric gland secrete less gastric juice. So this gastric juice is the mixture of what? Okay, gastric juice is the mixture of mucus. Is the mixture of mucus, hydrochloric acid, and pepsinogen. Okay, so three of them collectively known as the gastric juice. Okay, so the enzymes is the pepsinogen, and this pepsinogen is an inactive enzyme. So in what condition pepsinogen will be activated? So in the presence of HCl, hydrochloric acid. Okay, so pepsinogen will be activated to pepsin. Okay, so for pepsin, okay, the optimum pH for pepsin to work best is pH 1.5 to 2.0. so which means hydrochloric acid provides an acidic condition for pepsin to function the best. Okay, so the reaction in the stomach, okay, protein, okay, is hydrolyzed into polypeptide by pepsin. Okay boys, just now in the mouth, which is the digestion of carbohydrate or digestion of starch. Now we relate to in the beginning, I asked you to customize a pizza, and Jia Xuan, okay, he would prefer a thick crust. So this crust bing pi is made of carbohydrate starch, right? So the starch will be hydrolyzed, which means the crust will be hydrolyzed, the starch, okay, will be hydrolyzed in the mouth. And then the pizza we customized just now, okay, I add chicken breast. So chicken breast contains protein, and this protein will be hydrolyzed in the stomach, okay, into polypeptide by an enzyme known as pepsin. Okay, so that's fine. So food will stay in the stomach, okay, the substance will stay in the stomach for around 2 to 5 hours, okay, 2 to 5 hours. And now, this substance no longer food, we don't call this as a food, and we don't call this as a bolus again, okay, but we call this as a chyme, C-H-Y-M-E, okay, the substance stays in the stomach, is known as the chyme. Okay, so after staying for 2 to 5 hours, okay, in the stomach, so the muscle known as the sphincter muscle, okay, boys, let's see here, sphincter here actually is the name of muscle, it's a smooth muscle. So the sphincter muscle will relax, okay, relax, and now the chyme will leave the stomach and enters the duodenum. From the stomach, the chyme will move to the duodenum. Okay, so that's part. The third site of digestion, which is the duodenum. Okay, so duodenum, as I said, this is the first portion of the small intestine. Okay, which is a C, look like a C shape, this one. Duodenum, C shape. Okay, so in the duodenum, there are two different digestive glands, digestive juice. Okay, you see the first one. Okay, so in the duodenum, the digestive gland is the liver. Okay, now, actually, liver and duodenum is different parts, different organs. Okay, but duodenum is just a site, provide a place for digestion. But the digestive gland is another organ, which is the liver. So now the liver will secrete juice, which is known as the bile. So bile means 胆汁. Okay, so this bile contains bile pigments, and these bile pigments gives color to the bile. Okay, so the bile pigments gives color of the bile, which is the greenish yellow. Okay, so, and this bile provides an alkaline condition, which means its pH is around 7.6 to 8.6. So provides alkaline condition for the enzymes, for the digestive enzymes in the duodenum. Okay, now see. Okay, so this is the bile, and this color, which is greenish yellow. Okay, because it consists of bile pigments, and this bile pigment is not only for one pigment, there are several pigments that gives bile greenish yellow color. Okay, so the function of bile is to emulsify. Okay, emulsify here is, this is not a chemical, boys, this is not a chemical digestion, not a chemical digestion, because bile, this is not an enzyme, there is no enzyme reaction at all. Okay, so the lipid will be broken down into smaller droplets. Okay, I will use this term emulsify. Okay, which means break down into small droplets. So the bile emulsified lipid into lipid droplets. So why? Is to increase the total surface area for chemical digestion. Okay, so remember this part, this is not considered as a chemical digestion. Okay, let's see this diagram. Wow, it's very disgusting. So gallstones. Okay, gallstones, which means this is 胆石. Okay. So now we recall back what I told you previously. Okay, the liver, function of liver is to secrete bile, and the bile will be stored in the gallbladder. Okay, so let's say, not everyone, some people, okay, they have this health problem, which is known as the gallstone, 胆石. So in what situation gallstones will be formed? Okay, because of, okay, the excess, okay, production of cholesterol, this can cause the formation of gallstone, excess production of cholesterol. And the second one, when the bile cannot be emptied from the gallstone, which means the accumulation of bile inside the gallstone, and this bow will be hardened, okay, and forms deposits and form gallstone in the gallbladder. So what kind of person will face this kind of health problem? Okay, if a person tends to skip meal, okay, skip meal, or a person do not have this habit, okay, of having breakfast, so the probability, the chances of having gallstone is high. So why? If a person skips meal or no intake of breakfast, okay, so the bowel will not be released from the gallstone because there is no food enter your digestive tract. So bowel will not be released out from the gallstone. So, and therefore this bowel will be accumulated in the gallbladder and forms deposits and hardens, and there will be hardened and form the gallstone. So for the symptoms of people, symptoms for those people having gallstone, they'll feel pain at the right portion above your abdomen, right side, okay, right upper portion above your abdomen. Okay, so actually this gallstone can be removed by surgery. Okay, so the next one, okay, still in the duodenum. Okay, the second digestive gland, okay, just now I talked about the liver as the digestive gland. Now, which is the second gland, still in the duodenum. So this gland, which is the pancreas, okay, let's see where is the pancreas. Okay, so this leaf-like structure is the pancreas, and this pancreas gland secrete juice known as the pancreatic juice, okay? And this juice contains, wow, any enzymes, okay? Pancreatic amylase, okay? So amylase, just now I mentioned the amylase, which is the salivary amylase. And now this is the pancreatic amylase. Its function is same, but the site of digestion is different. One, which is secreted by the saliva. Another, which is secreted by the pancreas, so different gland, but the function is same, okay? Pancreatic amylase, trypsin, and lipase. So let's see, what is the reaction? Okay, so we know that amylase is to hydrolyze starch into maltose. So this equation, okay, there are three information in this equation. Starch, the substrate, is hydrolyzed into maltose, the products, by pancreatic amylase, the enzyme. So you need to mention the substrate, the product, as well as the enzyme. Okay, let's see. For trypsin, its function is to hydrolyze polypeptide. Okay, so in the stomach, protein is hydrolyzed into polypeptide. Now, polypeptide will be further hydrolyzed into shorter substance, shorter molecule known as peptide. From polypeptide to peptide, this process is known as hydrolysis, and its enzyme is trypsin. And the third one, lipid is hydrolyzed to glycerol and fatty acids by the enzyme known as the lipase. Okay, let's do a revision regarding to lipid. So a lipid contains one molecule of glycerol and three molecules of fatty acids. So the ratio is 1:3. Still remember or not? Okay, one glycerol molecule with three fatty acids molecule. Okay, can I proceed? Okay, the last part of digestion, at the site of digestion, which is in the ileum. So the ileum is the third portion of the small intestine. Okay, I repeat, small intestine consists of three portions. The first portion, which is the duodenum. The second portion, which is the jejunum. And the third portion, which is the ileum. Okay, so the diagram here shows the wall of the ileum. Okay, let's see. For the digestive gland, is known as the intestinal cells. They are the glands. And this intestinal cell secrete very easy, the name intestinal juice. But this juice contains a number of enzymes. Now, you need to spend some time for these enzymes. Okay, oh, before going to the enzymes, let's see. For intestinal juice, its pH is 7.6, which is slightly alkaline. Okay, so these are the enzymes: maltase, sucrase, lactase, rhepsin, lipase. Okay, now let's go to the next part. So in the ileum, what happens in the ileum? The sucrose will be hydrolyzed. Okay, the sucrose is hydrolyzed into their products, which means the glucose and fructose way. This one, I should not spend time to do revision. You should know, okay? And the enzyme is sucrase, okay? So now we have three types of disaccharide. We have SML. Wait, still remember of all, still remember or not SML. Okay, these three are the disaccharides. Hey, disaccharides. Okay, so the disaccharides are hydrolyzed by enzyme, and the enzyme, the name of the enzyme, we just follow the substrate. Okay, OSE change to ASE, the name OSE change to ASE, OSE change to ASE. Okay, so sucrase, lactase, maltase, and then the products. Okay, so next one, we go to the next part. For peptide, okay, so in the duodenum, polypeptide is hydrolyzed to peptide by an enzyme known as trypsin. Now, the peptide is further hydrolyzed into the final products known as the amino acids. And this enzyme is known as the erepsin. Okay, and the last one, okay, for those lipid, okay, for lipid that cannot be hydrolyzed, okay, the meat, I call this as a so-called missing. Those lipid that miss the hydrolysis process will continue their pathway to the ileum and then proceed this hydrolysis. So the lipid will be hydrolyzed into glycerols and fatty acids by lipase. Okay, so about the digestion, okay, we have three sets of digestion. Okay, the main is a three, okay, we have mouth, stomach, and small intestine. A small intestine can be divided into two parts, the duodenum and the ileum. Okay, so here's to the end of the lesson about digestion, but I still have homework for you. Don't go first. Okay, so okay, we come back to the lesson. Please wait a while. Okay, so let's do a recap. Okay, let's do a recap regarding to the lesson today. Okay, the first one is about digestion. Okay, there are two types of digestion. The first one is the physical digestion, and you must know what, how, why. And the second one, which is the chemical digestion, you also need to know what, how, why. Okay, so the next one, the second point for this part, for this lesson is about, for when we mention about the digestion, you need to know three things: digestive glands, digestive juice, as well as the digestive enzymes. Okay, and the last one, which is the four different types of sites of digestion, the places of digestion, the mouth, the stomach, and then the duodenum and the ileum. Okay, so before going to the next part, okay, which is the practice, okay, or exercise, okay, just now I asked Li Ziyang, hey, where is your answer? I'm waiting for an answer. Okay, I'm waiting for an answer. Okay, just now I asked two questions. The first question is about the fibers. So fibers, okay, when we consume fibers, okay, vegetables, okay, fruits contains fiber. Fiber cannot be hydrolyzed, cannot be digested. Why? Because fibers contains cellulose, which is a polysaccharide. But in the human digestive system, does not have cellulase. So since we do not have this enzyme, our body, our digestive system cannot hydrolyze cellulose. So we cannot hydrolyze fiber. Okay, so the second question is about minerals and vitamins, mineral and vitamins. So digestion of minerals and vitamins does not occur in the human digestive system. Give your reason. Okay, now I give you the answer about Li Ziyang. Okay, it's okay. Okay, if you do not have to answer the question, you just say, sir, I don't know. Okay. Okay, actually, I don't want you to spend time to search online because now you have time. You are now with me for the lesson. Okay. If you are searching for the answer, but at the end you cannot listen to my lecture, so you gain nothing. Okay, so now I give you the answer. For digestion of vitamins and minerals does not occur in the human digestive system because minerals and vitamins, they are small enough to diffuse across the epithelial cells of the intestine, which means they can be absorbed by the small intestine because they are small enough. But for lipid, for carbohydrate, for starch, for protein, they are large and complex molecules. Okay, so chemical digestion is needed to break down these molecules, large and complex molecules, into smaller, simple, and soluble molecules. Okay, so I repeat once again, for vitamins and minerals, because they are small enough to diffuse across the epithelial cells of the small intestine, which means they can be absorbed directly. Okay, so now let's do an exercise regarding to our lesson today. Okay, actually this is a summary. Okay, just now we customize our own pizza, right? Okay, so now let's see. Today I have another question. Okay, so now I want you to take out your long book. Okay, everyone, long book, get ready with your long book, L-O-N-G, long, B-O-O-K, book, ready, get ready with your long book. If no long book, okay, you just prepare a piece of paper, write it down first, jot down first, after that, you just transfer it to your long book. Okay, so get ready. Okay. So describe the chemical digestion. Now this is a question, huh? So questions in your long book. Now let's do this together. Okay, please copy this in your, to your long book. Okay, describe the chemical digestion. After Mr. Wong, add a slice of pizza containing, okay, now I write down everything. Okay, just now, Tan Jia Xuan, you order a pizza, okay, you like a thick crust containing thick crust, okay, and then pineapple, mushroom, and my favorite, chicken breast. Okay, so now, you see one by one. Okay, for thick crust, the crust actually is made of flour. The flour contains starch. Okay, pineapple, okay, so for chemical digestion, only three nutrients will be digested by chemical digestion. Okay, the first one, which is the carbohydrate. Okay, the second one, protein. And the last one, which is lipid, or another, which is cheese. I forgot already. Cheese, which is lipid. Okay, but for vitamins, okay, vitamins and these minerals cannot be digested. Okay, because not cannot be digested, there's no digestion is needed because they are small enough to diffuse across the wall of the small intestine. Okay, and for fibers, okay, fibers cannot be digested because our human digestive system, okay, does not produce cellulase to hydrolyze the cellulose. Okay, so let's see the first one, thin crust. For thin crust, what is the substrate? Okay, the nutrients in the thick crust, which is the starch. Okay, so later we'll talk about this. Okay, cheese, wow, it's very fattening, so it's lipid. Okay, next one, pineapple. So pineapple contain, for cheese is also contains, because this is a dairy product. So it contains the disaccharide known as lactose, right? Lactose. Okay, next one, for pineapple, okay, vitamins, we can ignore vitamins because they are small enough to diffuse across the wall of the small intestine. So we don't mention about the vitamins, minerals, just ignore, fiber, ignore. But for vitamins, it is sweet taste. So which means for pineapple, it tastes sweet because of the presence of sucrose. Okay, sucrose. So later we talk about this, okay, the hydrolysis of sucrose. Okay, so for mushroom, okay, fibers, okay, fibers no need to mention, okay, vitamins, minerals, okay, we just ignore mushroom. And for chicken breast, okay, for sure is protein. Okay, so now for your answers, okay, we go one by one. So for we start from thick crust. So this is your answer. So the thick crust of pizza contains what? Starch. Okay? And then hydrolysis, chemical digestion of starch. Okay, so for chemical digestion of starch, okay, the first one, it occurs in the mouth. The second, in the duodenum, as the pancreatic amylase hydrolyze the starch. So now, in the mouth or in the oral cavity, starch is hydrolyzed to maltose by what enzyme? Okay, so for this part, okay, in the what, this is a site of digestion, can be mouth, can be stomach, okay, can be the duodenum, can be the ileum. This is a substrate, is hydrolyzed to products by what enzymes? Okay, so this is the example for, I start from thick crust, okay? And even cheese, you can continue with the same method. Okay, cheese of pizza contains lipid in the what? Which means what is the site? Okay, the substrate, which means the lipid, is hydrolyzed to glycerol and fatty acid by enzyme lipase. Okay, so use the same method. Okay, use the same method for cheese, pineapple, and chicken breast. Okay, so this is just an example. I use thick crust of pizza as the example. Okay, so next one, okay, if this is as your homework, okay, everyone, you must do it in your long book. So, but before ending, let's do a summary, because actually I want you to do this summary first, then you only do the homework, the question. Okay, so summary, everyone must do it now. Okay, so this is a summary, summary. Okay, digestion. Okay, sorry, I use hydrolysis. I prefer use hydrolyze instead of digestion. Okay, hydrolysis of carbohydrate. Okay, so this summary is according to three classes of food: the carbohydrate, proteins, and lipid. Okay, so hydrolysis of carbohydrate. Okay, so starch is hydrolyzed to maltose, right? And maltose is hydrolyzed to glucose, glucose plus glucose lah. Okay, so now from starch to maltose to glucose, we need enzymes, right? And that there is different sets of digestion. Okay, so now I use different thing. You may use different colors. So starch is hydrolyzed by salivary amylase, as well as the pancreatic amylase. Okay, and then maltose is hydrolyzed to glucose and the enzymes, which is the maltase. So I use red color to represent the enzymes. Okay, so where is the site of digestion? So I use purple color to represent. Okay, so for the chemical digestion of starch, it occurs in the mouth, okay, as well as in the duodenum. Okay, the next one, for the hydrolysis of maltose to glucose, it takes place in the ileum. Okay, so this one is for hydrolysis of carbohydrate, but we don't forget, okay, we still have disaccharide. So for disaccharide, other than maltose, we have sucrose as well. Okay, sucrose is hydrolyzed to glucose and fructose. Okay, and then we have lactose. Lactose is hydrolyzed to glucose and galactose. Okay, same using the red color to represent the enzyme. So sucrose is hydrolyzed to glucose and fructose by sucrase. Okay, and lactose is hydrolyzed to glucose and galactose by lactase. And then I use the purple color to represent the site of digestion. So this hydrolysis takes place in the ileum, and same goes to the hydrolysis of lactose. Okay, so from this method, okay, you will clear about the hydrolysis of carbohydrates. Okay, and in this whole image, you will know, okay, the substrate and the products, the enzyme, as well as the site of digestion. Okay, so now you can apply this summary to the homework. Okay, let's see. Now I return here. First, you mentioned about the ingredients. Okay, the thick crust of pizza contains what nutrients? The second, in the what site? What substrate is hydrolyzed to what product by enzyme? Okay, so you can apply what I told you just now in the summary on this and on answering these questions. Okay, so now I go back to the summary part. Okay, so this is for hydrolysis of carbohydrate. So next one, which is the hydrolysis of protein. The second, hydrolysis of protein. Okay, so the first one, protein is hydrolyzed to polypeptide. Okay, and polypeptide is hydrolyzed to peptide. And finally, peptide is hydrolyzed to amino acids. Okay, so next one, I use red color to represent the enzymes. From protein to polypeptide, the enzyme is the pepsin. Okay, and then from polypeptide to peptide, this enzyme is trypsin. The enzyme is trypsin. And from peptide to amino acid, the enzyme is urepsin. This is R. Okay, and the site of digestion, I use purple color. From protein to polypeptide, hydrolysis takes place in the stomach. Okay, and then from polypeptide to peptide, hydrolysis takes place in the duodenum. And from peptide to amino acid, ileum. So it's this overall image is very clear. Okay, from where, from what substance to what substance, and what enzymes are needed, and what are the sites of digestion. Okay, so you can apply this on your questions. Okay, chicken breast. Okay, we applied in our on our question just now. Chicken breast of the pizza contains protein. Okay, clear. Protein. First we mentioned the site in the stomach. Protein is hydrolyzed to polypeptide by pepsin. In the duodenum, polypeptide is hydrolyzed to peptide by trypsin. In the ileum, peptide is hydrolyzed to amino acid in diurepsin. Okay, it's clear. Next one, the last one, which is the hydrolysis of lipid. Number three, this is summary, you can jot down in your long book. Okay, hydrolysis of lipid. Okay, so first, the lipid is emulsified into lipid droplets. Okay, instead of using the arrow, I use this dotted one. Okay, this means emulsified. Okay, emulsified by the bowel into lipid droplets. Okay, and then this lipid droplets is hydrolyzed to glycerol and fatty acids. Okay, so now I use the red color one to represent the enzyme first, because of this lipid is emulsified into lipid droplets by bowel. So bowel is not an enzyme. So I do not use red color. Instead of that, I use green color. Okay, yeah, bowel, because this is not an enzyme. Emulsified by bowel. Okay, and where does it occur? In the duodenum. Okay, you can say so. Okay, cheese contains lipid. Cheese contains lipid. Next one, in the duodenum, lipid is emulsified. Use emulsified instead of hydrolyzed. Emulsified by bowel into lipid droplets. Okay, that's okay. This will do. Next one, the lipid droplets will be hydrolyzed by an enzyme known as lipase to glycerol and fatty acids. So I use red color to represent the enzyme. And the site of digestion, I use the purple color. So lipase, it's found in the duodenum as well as in the ileum. Okay, so this image is very clear. That tells you the hydrolysis of three different food nutrients, okay, the carbohydrates, okay, the proteins, as well as lipids. So you can read this horizontally from the left to right, from the substrate to the end products. And at the same time, you know what are the enzymes needed for the hydrolysis and where is the site of digestion. And then you apply this 1, 2, 3, okay, apply this 1, 2, 3 in the questions I gave you just now. Okay, so this is the end of the lesson. So if you have any question, you may ask, okay, in our group chat, okay, our messenger group chat, or even through the Google Classroom. Okay, so this is your homework, and tomorrow I will assign another homework. It's a very simple homework for you. Okay, Tomorrow, please check your Google Classroom. Okay, if you have any question regarding to today's lesson, please okay, ask question. Okay, type in the chat box. Okay, I can answer you. Okay, within okay, the time now is 4:25. Okay, hopefully I can stop it before 4:30 because I know some of you are very busy with other online classes. Okay, so if you have question regarding the digestion, please ask question. You can type in the chat box. Okay, so if you have no question, okay, you just can leave this video, okay, just off the YouTube. But don't forget, okay, if you feel that this lesson is very useful to you, just click a like, okay, please click a like, okay, to support Tam Xuan, to support Mr. Tam, okay. And if you feel to ask any question, you just can stay here, okay, type your question, I will answer your questions, okay, you have problems regarding to digestion, okay. So do not hesitate to ask. So now I'm waiting for any question. So the time now is 4:23 and I will stop broadcasting at 4:30. So if you have any question to ask, you may ask now. Okay, goodbye class. Okay, if you have question, you can ask. If you have no question, you just leave. It's okay. Okay, see you next week. Okay, goodbye Ho Chi, goodbye Rong Sheng, goodbye Yong Ping, goodbye Xiao Qian. Okay, bye, Stephen. Don't feel shy to ask if you have question, if you want to ask. Okay, bye, Jia Xuan. Bye, Junwei. Bye, Zihong. Goodbye, Xin Kai. Goodbye, Jian Jun. Goodbye, Henry. Okay, see you, Yao Ming. Okay, since there's no question, I will end the broadcast right now. Okay, goodbye and see you next week and take care, everyone. Bye-bye.